The first step in learning how to type properly is learning the home row. If you aren't yet comfortable and familiar with the home row, I recommend that you watch my typing tutorial for beginners video and practice those letters a bit. Now, downloading a finger chart and knowing where to rest your fingers when they're not typing is a solid start. But how do we progress from here? Sure, you could just go for it. You could start not looking at the keyboard, trying to use the right finger for the right key, and just go about your daily tasks, and you will become a better typer. But it might take a little bit longer if you do that. Wouldn't it be nice if you could put your fingers through some sort of boot camp? Well, you can. In fact, you probably should. This will allow you to focus more intently on touch typing and not mix it with other tasks so much. I recommend that you start branching out from the home row, starting with the index fingers, followed by the middle fingers, then the ring fingers, and then finally your pinky fingers. Now, with that being said, there is one key, or really two keys, that are typed by our pinky fingers that are very important, and so I do want to go over that now, and then we're going to get into our index fingers. The keys that I'm talking about are the shift keys. So if we take a look over here at my keyboard, you'll notice that we have two shifts on the keyboard, one here on the left side typed by the left pinky, and one here on the right side typed by the right pinky. Now, if you want to do things by the book, you should always be using the shift key that is opposite of the letter that you're typing. So if I were to type, say, a capital T, my left pointer is going to do the T, so I should be using my right pinky for shift. Alternatively, if I were going to type a capital U, I would use my left pinky for shift back here, and then I would type U. It's a good idea to start practicing these shift keys early on. They're pretty important keys that are used a lot. Actually, they're used at least once per sentence, right? And it also is really good practice because it gets your whole hand into touch typing. You're going to have to really start to focus on getting back to the home row. You might start to lose your position on the keyboard a little bit, but that gives you practice in finding your way back. So definitely start to work out your pinkies a little bit at this point with those shift keys. But now let's go ahead and let's move our focus over to our index fingers. Each index finger is responsible for six primary letters and two numbers, including their home row key. The right index finger is responsible for the letters Y, U, H, J, N, and M. It's also responsible for the numbers 6 and 7. So those are all of the primary responsibilities for the right index finger. Your left index finger is responsible for the letters R, T, F, G, V, and B. Your left index finger is also responsible for the numbers 4 and 5. Learning these letters is where you should focus after you're comfortable with the home row. To start, I recommend you just open up a blank document and start typing these letters repetitively. So for example, I could type with my left hand 4, then back to the home row, then 5, back to the home row, R, T, F, G, V, B. Then with the right hand, I could go 6, 7, Y, U, H, J, N, M. You'll notice I broke a little rule there at the end. I didn't go back to the home row, right? You want to focus on always doing that. And you can just type these letters repetitively, and you could alternate a little bit. Maybe the next time you could alternate the hands, and you could do something like 4, then 6, then 5, then 7, then R, then U, then T, then Y, then G, then H, then F, then J, then B, then N, then V, then M. Right? And so now I've alternated them, and I can start putting some spaces in there as well. And once you start getting comfortable, start using shift. So I can do capital U, I can do capital Y. I can start doing some spaces, like I said, capital N, capital M. Remember to return your fingers to the home row in between keystrokes to build up your muscle memory. If a particular finger is giving you a really hard time, or maybe a particular keystroke, maybe I'm having trouble with this R, I recommend that you make that keystroke repetitively. R space R, just go back and just keep doing it. I know it might seem kind of boring and like, what's going on here? First of all, it makes your fingers more nimble, but then second of all, it continues to build that connection between your brain and your fingers, continuing to build muscle memory so that if you need to type that letter R, you don't have to think about it. Your finger just goes boom, R. That's it. You don't even realize you're doing it. That's what our goal is, and that's where you're going to get. You just need to keep on putting in that work. I promise you, I can type quite fast, but there is not a single part of my conscious brain that is thinking about what letter I'm typing when I'm typing. It is automatic. To speed up your ability to type fast on a computer, doing these repetitive keystrokes is your best bet. You want to type the letter Y really fast? Well, use your right index finger without looking, returning to the home row in between, and do that, say, 1,000 times, maybe a little bit more. I can almost guarantee you that after that, you will be able to type that letter Y without thinking about it. You just need to practice and do the repetition to build that muscle memory. Again, I know that sounds repetitive in and of itself, but when we talk about touch typing, we can give you all the lessons that we can. I can show you, hey, this is how you do this finger. You have got to do the practice. That's the only way. I'm not watching you, but you should be watching yourself and making sure that you're practicing. If I do come across any typing hypnotists, however, I will be sure to let you know. In the meantime, however, get those fingers moving as fast as you can on that keyboard, and I will see you in the next lesson. If you found this video helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more technology tips and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. That's all I have for you for now. This is Anson from AnsonAlex.com.